Hello and welcome to the first of our bada technical training videos. The bada architecture is made up of four principal layers: framework, service, device and kernel. Let's take a look at those layers now. First off, we have the kernel layer. This features a real-time OS or Linux kernel depending on hardware configuration. Next is the device layer, including the core functions, which are memory, I/O management, security management, graphics, window and event management, data protocols and telephony, audio, visual and multimedia management. Then we have the service layer with the application engines and server-assisted components. This includes application engines such as interconnecting with the bada server and web runtime. And finally, the framework layer, the open API framework that consists of application framework and the functions exported by underlying layers. This includes fundamental namespaces, UI and graphics namespaces, communication namespaces, and service-centric namespaces. In this video, we will look in greater detail at the Open API framework and its features and services, examining each namespace in turn. Let's start with the social namespace. This enables developers to quickly and easily build their own communities with full support for address book and calendar book. You'll also get additional services such as personal information management, group management, profiles and board services. Location namespace enable context-aware personalized services such as location provider and landmark store management. Also included are map, geocoding directory, and root services. Media and content namespaces provide unified content management and processing features. In particular, audio-video playback, camera control facilities, and recording. Other features include image handling, content data management, and search and content transfer. The commerce namespace enables in-application purchasing and item information management, all supported by the Samsung Application Store. The graphics namespace supports drawing-related functions such as 2D graphics, vector fonts, bitmaps, drawing primitives, and 3D graphics support via OpenGL ES. The network namespace provides you with network account management, raw socket API, fully implemented HTTP protocols, and Bluetooth and Wi-Fi. The telephony namespace provides full telephony operations support for voice, video, SIM query services, network information query services, and also network management. The messaging namespace supports the sending of SMS, MMS and email messages, including attachments. The UI namespaces define UI programming models and provide visual graphical libraries. The UI base provides event-related classes and interfaces, as well as common base classes for all controls. The UI containers support frame and forms in both portrait and landscape orientations, as well as pop-up, panel menu, and message box containers. The security namespace supports a platform-wide security system and advanced security services such as cryptographic algorithms, certificate management services, key management, and user authentication with single sign-on. The base namespace provides you with the basic data types such as object, string, date time, byte buffer, UUID, and others in the bada platform. It also provides runtime, collections, utility functions, and standard C++ libraries. The device namespace supports the synchronization of personal data, including contact, event, and to-do lists between the bada device and the bada server. This server supports vCard and vCalendar, with synchronization carried out by SyncML. The I/O namespace is for input-output data handling. It implements file handler, database and registry, where applications can store and retrieve settings. The text namespace provides conversion between major text encoding schemes, such as UTF-8, UCS2, Latin-1, ASCII, and GSM. The locale namespace allows you to identify specific language code, country code, and variant code. The application namespace provides you with the API to handle application type, native application controls, and lifecycle management. Examples include initializing, terminating, resource allocation, and cleanup. XML and web namespaces allow you to have full control of web content and integrate the XML parser into your applications. Browser and JavaScript utilities can also be found under the web namespace. The system namespace allows you to retrieve or set device system information, such as battery level, alarm settings, vibration, power management, and others. These are the key features and services you'll find supported on the bada platform. Please keep checking the website for further updates and more technical walkthroughs. Thanks for watching.